I'm here with Kristan Hawkins, president of Students for Life of America. Kristan, thanks so much for joining me. Talk to me about how Students for Life is engaging in Kansas with the Value Them Both amendment vote coming up, as well as the primary on August 2nd.
Yes, Kansas is an important fight for the pro-life movement. I think a lot of folks haven't heard what's going on, so I'm so excited to see all the EWTN's doing to really get the word out about the significance of this amendment. We've been involved since 2019 in this fight. That is when, you know, their Supreme Court in Kansas found a quote-unquote right to abortion hidden in invisible ink in the state constitution, and lawmakers decided that they were going to take this to the people. And unfortunately, then in 2019, we had some Republican members of the legislature who voted against that initiative. Students for Life was there with Kansans for Life, and we were door knocking in their primary in 19 or 20, door knocking, getting folks out, telling people about, you know, Republicans who weren't voting pro-life at the state house. And so we've been following this. So once this eventually, we got, you know, this majority there in Topeka who said, yes, let's get to the ballot, we knew we had to act. And so we've got one of our former student alumni, she's out there door knocking, recruiting others to door knock, partnering with Kansans for Life. I was actually there this spring door knocking myself. We'll have some students flying and busing in by the end of summer as well.
Wow, very exciting. And, you know, speak to me about your strategy at Students for Life to engage young people all over the country in this fight to end abortion. You know, how does it impact your ability to activate when it comes to something like the Value Them Both Amendment?
I think it's a really great example for students of why getting involved matters, and this and the difference that they can create in the world, the transformation that they can make by getting involved. This isn't just, you know, having a fight on Twitter with somebody who disagrees with your opinion on abortion. This is going door to door and educating voters and asking them to go out and vote for life and to affirm in this case that the Kansas Constitution does not say women have the right to pay someone to end the life of their child. Mm-hmm. And I think that that's what these sorts of fights, you know, whether we're talking about this specific ballot referendum or when we get into later into the fall into the 2022 midterms, this gives young people a way to really put their pro-life beliefs into action.
I love it. And I also wanted to hear from you from some on the federal level about the left's response to Roe. You recently commented on the case of a 10-year-old girl who was raped. She reportedly traveled from Ohio to Indiana to receive an abortion. And, you know, President Biden amplified this, focusing on the fact that this girl needs an abortion rather than the fact that she was raped. What are your thoughts on all of this?
I was outraged when I heard the president. He literally highlighted this case. At the time, we didn't even have the full facts. He never mentioned the rapist, if the girl had been removed from, you know, was she living with the rapist? You know, was she being protected? Never mentioned any sexual assault healing, anything that she would actually have to, will now have to go through. He simply used this case to make a political speech, because seconds after talking about this tragic story, he says, and now you have to go out and vote. He used the sexual assault of a 10-year-old to tell people to go out and vote for Democrats in November. And it was outrageous as a mother to think of, I mean, we have all, if you have young children, whether it's your child or grandchild, to think of your 10-year-old daughter or your grandchild being raped, becoming pregnant, and then to have the president of the United States go on national TV and not talk about helping her, simply talking about ending human life and then using it as a justification to vote for Democrats. It was morally outrageous, and every American should be appalled by what he did.
Right. And also, last week on Friday, Democrats in the House voted on two radical abortion bills. You know, Senator Elizabeth Warren, she's calling for a crackdown on pro-life pregnancy centers. What do Democrats hope to achieve when the majority of Americans reject their agenda on this?
Yeah, the gaslighting of the abortion industry has become so clear. So for years, we've been told in the pro-life movement, and I hear this all the time, I'm sure you have,
right,
that pro-lifers don't care about women. We don't do anything to help women after they don't choose abortion. We just want them barefoot and pregnant in the kitchen. They always ignore that we have 3,000 pregnancy resource centers, 400 maternity homes, that we've been supporting, sustaining an entire social safety network for 50 years. Right? They've just completely ignored it. Now we have the left coming out and saying, oh yeah, they have all of these places, but we want to shut them down. Or we want to blow them up or vandalize them. I mean, it's unbelievable what you're hearing, the rhetoric that you're hearing, the fact that the mainstream media isn't even holding these people accountable. I mean, think about Senator Warren saying this. The person, the media person they're talking to should be saying, wait a minute, you don't think women who simply don't want to have an abortion that may need help with diapers or formula shouldn't get that help? Because I've been in the Planned Parenthoods pregnant. They do not have formula. They don't have diapers. They don't have parenting classes. They don't have access to maternity clothes. They don't do any of that. That is exactly what this entire social safety network that we've set up has done.
Right. Right. Well, we have to keep exposing them for, you know.
I don't know what memo they're reading.
Right.
Because, I mean, like, nothing that you're reading, no conversation that you have about abortion, do you find people who say, yes, I want abortion all 9 months for whatever reason, even if the child's a girl and the mom doesn't want a girl, I'm okay with that and should be taxpayer funded. Nobody says that.
Right. Well, thank you so much for joining us and for your insight on this. Kristan Hawkins of Students for Life.
Thanks for having me.